But first to our top story. There are reports tonight at least 15 asylum seekers have drowned after their Australia-bound boat sank off the coast of Indonesia. More than 20 survivors have been recovered. And this isn't the first boat rescue of asylum seekers in the troubled waters between the neighbouring nations today. So for the latest, Adam Todd joins us now live from Canberra. Adam, what's the latest?
Danny, we're hearing that death toll of 15 could rise as the search for survivors continues, and tragically, a number of the dead are children. But as you say, this is the second time in 24 hours we've seen an asylum seeker vessel in distress. Earlier, it was the Australian Navy who came to the rescue of another vessel in distress. Rescued by Australians, but going back to Indonesia.
You want to die? Problems.
44 asylum seekers, including four children, picked up from their stricken boat by the Australian Navy, 40 nautical miles off the Indonesian coast. But this was a rescue, not a turn back. Indonesia giving the Navy permission to enter their waters. Cooperation here, but Indonesia is showing there'll be no such collaboration if the Navy turns back boats. A spokeswoman for Indonesia's vice president saying such a move risks conflict between the two countries.
If Australia did something foolish, obviously it could be, but the incoming government will not do foolish things.
Yesterday, Indonesia released details of this meeting between Foreign Minister Julie Bishop and her Indonesian counterpart, Marty Natalegawa, where he warned turning back boats risked trust and cooperation. Today, Indonesia said releasing those details was a mistake, but the substance of the message wasn't denied.
It takes a special effort to endanger such an important bilateral relationship in the first week of office.
A former foreign minister pointing the finger at Indonesia.
Instead of a lot of pious rhetoric about the Australian government threatening their sovereignty, they are breaching their people, their boats, their crews are breaching our sovereignty.
Well, look, Alexander is Alexander, and I'm now the Prime Minister of our country.
And it's in this fraught climate Mr Abbott is making his first overseas trip as Prime Minister to Jakarta on Monday.
The last thing that anyone should want is to have Australia's relationship with Indonesia defined by this boats issue, which I am sure will be but a passing irritant.
Just last month, he said border security was a national emergency.
All right, Adam, now, you mentioned there Mr Abbott's trip to Indonesia. How will that play out now, do you think?
Well, certainly the asylum seeker issue is going to be the focal point of this visit. This, he said for a long time that Jakarta would be his first trip as Prime Minister, and he's fulfilling that pledge. Now, he's played down, as you saw there, the issue of asylum seekers, but there's no doubt it will be the focal point.
Canberra.